Students often struggle with equivalent fractions. Like, does 1 half and 3 sixths have the same value? Can equivalent fractions go on forever? And is simplifying fractions related to equivalent fractions somehow? We'll answer these questions, get you lots of practice, and by the end of the video, you'll be a pro at equivalent fractions. Let's get started. Let's find equivalent fractions for 2/3. So we can't simplify 2/3 any further. So what we need to do is multiply. Let's multiply the numerator and the denominator by 2. Remember, 2 divided by 2, that's just 1, so we're only multiplying by 1. We don't change the value, just the way it's written. 2 times 2 is 4, 3 times 2 is 6. We end up with, and 4 sixths, that's an equivalent fraction for 2/3. Divide 2 by 3 or 4 by 6, you get the same decimal value. They're equivalent. How about if we take 2/3 and multiply by 3? So 2 times 3, 6, 3 times 3, 9, and 6/9, that's an equivalent fraction to 2/3 and to 4/6. And as long as the numerator and the denominator are the same, you can use any numbers. So pause, find equivalent fractions for 3/4. So here's how I did it. First, I multiplied the numerator and the denominator by 2. 2 times 3 is 6, 2 times 4 is 8, 6/8. 3/4 and 6/8 are equivalent fractions. Divide 3 by 4, 6 by 8, you get the same thing, 0.75. Then I did this. Here I used 7 over 7. I was feeling a little crazy. But 21/28, that's an equivalent fraction to 3/4. Both of them are equal to 0.75. Sometimes you'll have fractions you need to simplify. For example, 7 over 21. 7 goes into both of these numbers. 7 divided by 7, that's 1. 21 divided by 7, that's 3. So an equivalent fraction to 7/21, that's 1/3. So we just simplified this. If you need help, there's a link to a video on simplifying fractions at the end of this one. And if we want another equivalent fraction, let's do this. 1 times 2 is 2, 3 times 2 is 6. 2/6, that's an equivalent fraction to 1/3 and to 7 over 21. Okay, I want to show you something real quick that'll really help you get this. Take a circle, divide it in half. Let's shade this side in. So this side, that's 1/2. Let's cut those halves in half. Now we have 4 pieces, each one 1/4. So we have 1/4 plus 1/4. That equals 2/4. And that's an equivalent fraction. They represent the same area. Let's do it again. Let's cut these in half. 8 pieces, each piece 1/8. 1/8, 2/8, 3/8, 4/8. 2/4, equivalent fraction to 4/8. It's the same area, just a different name. Divide 1 by 2, 2 by 4, or 4 by 8, you'll get 0.5 for all of them. They are equivalent. Let's do some more practice. All right, you try this last one here. Pause, give it a shot. Here's how I did it. I know that 5 goes into each of these numbers. So 15 divided by 5 is 3. 3 times 5 is 15. 35 divided by 5, that's 7. 7 times 5 is 35. That's an equivalent fraction. And let's get one more equivalent fraction. How about numerator and denominator will multiply by 3? You could have also multiplied 15 and 35 by 2. That would give you another equivalent fraction. The possibilities are endless. So jump over to the practice video to really lock in your learning. This is Dr. B. Thanks for watching.